My name is Salim Sumat Janu from Department of Physics, Manipur University. The topic of my presentation is the influence of Jung's and nanoparticles on structural, optical, and topographies of olefin and alcohol films. Here is the outline of my work. Introduction, synthesis of Jung's and nanoparticles by co-precipitation method and PVA Jung's and nanocomposite by solution casting method. Next, characterizations of the synthesized samples by X-ray diffraction technique, Fourier transform, infrared spectroscopy, transmitting spectroscopy, and UV visible stress spectroscopy. The data properties of the synthesized sample by LCR meter, and conclusion. Here is the introduction of my work. We have synthesized the polymer nanocomposite because polymer nanocomposite had become the point of interest to many researchers because of their ability to control mechanical, electrical, and optical property. Among the polymer, PBA has been used as a host polymer to fabricate polymer nanocomposite due to its unique properties such as easy processability, bad biocompatibility, excellent film forming character, hydrophilicity, biodegradability, high flexibility, transmittance, good electrical and optical properties, good dielectric strength, and the sulfurous capacity. Among the metal oxide, zinc oxide is used because of its wide band gap energy and shows good electrical and optical properties, which have led its wide use in a variety of industrial and technological applications and chemical sensors, piezoelectric films, photovoltaic applications. By combining the properties of PBA and zinc oxide, it forms a hybrid material with low band gap, high dielectric permittivity, high breakdown voltage, and energy storage density, with fine applications in sensor, OLED, and capacitors as electric energy storage devices. This is for the synthesis of zinc oxide by co-precipitation method and PVA zinc oxide nanocomposite by solution casting method. For the synthesis of zinc oxide by co-precipitation method, an appropriate amount of zinc acetate is dissolved in 700 ml of distilled water. It was stirred for half an hour. Then, sodium hydroxide, which acts as a precipitating agent, is added by drop to the zinc acetate solution until the pH becomes 12. Then, YPPT start forming. Then, the YPPT was filtered and dried in an oven. Then, we obtain the zinc oxide nanoparticles. Next is the synthesis of PBA zinc oxide nanocomposite by solution casting method. Here, the appropriate amounts of PBA is dissolved in hot distilled water. Then it was stirred until it becomes transparent. Then the solution was divided into 5 equal parts. Then the desired 5% of zinc oxide is dissolved in the in its solute PBA solution. Then it was ultrasonicated for about 1 hour. Then the solution was poured into petri dish, and then it was dry in an oven for about 4 hours. Then PBA zinc oxide nanocomposite film is obtained. Then the films were filled up from the petri dish for further characterization. The structural properties of the synthesized samples was characterized by the X-ray diffraction. Figure A shows the excited patterns of zinc oxide nanoparticles, and it confirms the formations of hexagonal vertical structure with a crystallized size of 20 nanometer. And figure B shows the excited patterns for PVA zinc oxide nanocomposite. Here, a broad and intense peak obtains at 19.42 degree in all the samples indicates that PBA is a semicrystalline, has a semicrystalline nature. That semicrystalline nature arises due to the intermolecular or intramolecular interaction take place between the polymer chain. And with the addition of zinc oxide into the PBA, new peak emerges at angle 31, 34, 36, 47, 56, 62. This confirms the formations of PBA zinc oxide nanocomposite. The intensity of the peak is increases when the proportions of xenocytes dissolved in PBA increases. This indicates the interfacial interaction takes place between the PBA and the xenocyte. The functional properties of the synthesized samples was characterized by a Fourier transform infrared and a transmittance by the transmittance spectroscopy. Figure A shows the FTI spectrum. From the FTI spectrum, a strong peak appeared at the wavelength 438 cm in burst. At the bottom spectrum is due to the privations of zinc and oxygen, and a broad peak in the range from 3000 to 2600 cm in burst is assigned to the always stressing privations of PBA. The intensity and the peak positions of some band is shifted. This indicates that there is an intermolecular interaction take place between the PBA and the zinc. For figure, we saw the transmittance spectra here. The PBA shows a 90% transparency in the visible range. When the PBA forms composite with zinc oxide, its transparency decreases in the visible region and is completely blocked in the UV region. So this material can be used as an ultraviolet protection film during the irradiation of human skin and control the UV dose to the patient. The optical properties of the synthesized sample were characterized by the UV visible spectroscopy here. Figure A shows the absorption peak for the synthesized sample here. The absorption S for PBA is observed at around 200 nanometer, and the absorption peak of the remaining samples is shifted with the increasing wet persons of zinc oxide in the PBA. This is due to the formations of intra or intermolecular hydrogen bonding existing between the zinc oxide ions with the adjacent OH group of the PBA main stand. Then the energy band gap calculated from the absorption peak using the Taux plot is found that the for PBA, the energy band gap is 5.52 electron bond, and its energy band gap decreases when forming composite when increasing the wave presence of zinc oxide in the PBA from 3.22 electron bond, 3.19 electron bond, 3.16 electron bond, and 3.13 electron bond respectively for 5 wave percent, 10 wave percent, 15 wave percent, 20 wave percent of zinc oxide in a PBA polymer. The dielectric properties of the synthesized samples were characterized by the LCR meter. Figure A shows the variations of dielectric constant with frequency here. The dielectric constant is high at the lower frequency regions and it decreases with the increasing frequency. This is due to the interfacial polarization takes place between the PBA and the zinc oxide. And figure B shows the variations of dielectric loss with frequency here. The dielectric loss is high at the lower frequency regions and it decreases with increasing frequency. This is also due to interfacial polarization take place. And figure C shows the variations of AC conductivity with frequency here. The AC conductivity is high at the higher frequency region due to the excess charge carrier developed in the polymer stand. And the variations of dielectric constant with temperature for the 5% zinc oxide nanocomposite is measured, and from that the transition temperature is observed at 20 degrees Celsius. From the dielectric measurement, we observe that 5% zinc oxide PBA nanocomposite shows the maximum dielectric constant, dielectric loss, and AC conductivity. So this material can be used as a potential candidate for the flexible type microelectronic devices. Here is the conclusion of my work. PBA zinc oxide nanocomposite with various proportions of zinc oxide nanoparticles were successfully synthesized by the solution casting method. Exciting study confirmed the successful formations of PBA zinc oxide nanocomposite. After analysis shows good interactions between the PBA and zinc oxide nanocomposite. From the transmitting spectra, the transmittance is completely blocked in the UV region, so it can be used for UV protection film. And UV visible absorption spectrum confirms the formation of intramolecular and intermolecular hydrogen bonding with the addition of zinc oxide nanoparticles. From the dielectric properties, the maximum dielectric constant dielectric loss AC conductivity were observed at PBA 58% zinc oxide nanocomposite. So this material can be used as a potential candidate for flexible type microelectronic devices. Thank you.